2003, the New Jersey-based Di Cavalcanti family admitted, some of the guys admitted that they killed their boss, John D'Amato, because he was gay. You get the feeling these gangsters aren't really well adjusted, you know? So this guy, Anthony Capo, says that he killed D'Amato in 1992. D'Amato was a very close friend of John Gotti's in New York, and he went down to Little Italy a lot, which is where Gotti had his headquarters in the 1990s, 1980s, 1990s. In 1990, as an example, D'Amato was overheard on an FBI bug plotting to kill one of his soldiers, a guy named Gaetano Vastello, Corky Vastello, who Gotti thought was an informer. He said, "I don't know if he's a rat now, but he's going to be a rat someday." "Yeah," Gotti said. "And that's the way I feel about him." Oddly enough, Vastola lived through several attempts on his life. He completed a long prison sentence, never became an informer. When the FBI agents were assigned to watch the Gambino Club, where they first saw D'Amato at the Ravenite Club, they thought that D'Amato was U.S. Senator Alphonse D'Amato. And there's a slight resemblance, and D'Amato often said that the senator was his cousin, who weren't related. D'Amato had a wife and a girlfriend, and he talked about it a lot. Where he got into trouble was one of his girlfriends complained to Anthony Capo, this guy Capo, who said that D'Amato had been frequenting these sex clubs, which was fine by mob standards, but that he was occasionally having sex with men when he was there. The quote is from Capo, Anthony Capo. "She told me John D'Amato and her were going to sex club in the city, swapping partners, and John was engaging in homosexual activity. I questioned her over and over to make sure she was telling me the truth. She begged me not to tell anybody." And then Capo concluded by saying he was disgusted. I imagine by the gay thing, not the partner swapping. So they sat down, there was a meeting, and thought, "Well, we got to kill him. What's we going to do? They're going to lose respect for our family, blah, blah, blah." The problem is, of course, John D'Amato was a boss, and they'd have to get the sanction from the National Commission, which they weren't going to get, or they didn't have, or whatever the problem. They weren't going to wait around to find out. So they went to the family consigliere, the family advisor, Stefano Vitabile, Vitabile. I goofed that up. It's probably Vitabile. Who knows? Anyway, he approved the hit. So, according to Capo, he and several others picked D'Amato up at his girlfriend's house and shot him dead in the back seat of the car before it had even turned the street from the girlfriend's house. He said, "John D'Amato got in the car, sat in the back. He said, 'Let's go eat.' And as we drove away, I turned and I shot John D'Amato."